गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू अ नेक्स्ट सेशन ऑफ इंग्लिश ग्रामर. दैट इज अ न्यू टॉपिक. वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू स्टार्ट टुडे, बट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस व्हाट एवर होमवर्क वॉज गिवन टू यू. सो मंडे इज अ रीकैप डे, सो लेट्स डिस्कस द एक्सरसाइज दैट आई हैव गिवन यू फॉर होमवर्क. सो आई टुक द टॉपिक सब्जेक्ट एंड प्रेडिकेट एंड इट्स ऑन पेज नंबर 21. And on the beginning page, there is one picture given over there, and I have asked you to describe that picture. So some words based on subjects you need to fill, and some predicates you need to fill. So that was your homework. So just start. Take up the first sentence in your books. Dash is cycling along the road. So by looking at the picture, you could have written any name as your subject. For example, I have written Rohan is cycling on the road. We can see whom? We can see a boy, small boy cycling on the road. So I have written a name of a boy. You can write down any name as per your wish. Then second sentence, Dash is crossing the road. Now who is trying to cross the road? Just see in the picture again. We can see a boy crossing the road. So again I have written the name of a boy, that is Rohit is crossing the road. So this way you can also write down any name of the boy. Then some students are Dash. Now you can see some of the students, what are they doing? Some of the students are playing football. So you can write down anything, but only that is given in the picture. What you can see in the picture is that some students are playing in the road, on the road. So one of the girl is trying to cross the road, boy is also trying to cross the road, one boy is cycling, and then some children are there who is just entering the bus for the school. So what you can write is some students are playing football. So this way you can complete your sentence by writing your own predicate. The bus driver is Dash. You can see what is the bus driver doing. The bus driver is taking the children to school. So what you can write is taking the children to school. He is waiting at the bus stop. Even this you can write. The bus driver is waiting at the bus stop. So this way you can complete your predicate. So moving on to next page now, this page number 22 and 23, there are some rules that I have asked you to go through. The rules I have already explained you, it was for your self revision. So coming to page number 24, there was one exercise in which we have to tell what type of sentence it is. So this we have already discussed, I am not going to take it again. Then underline the subjects in these assertive sentences. Now what you have to do, there is 10 sentences are given and you need to just underline the subject, and they are very simple sentences. So this was given for homework. Let's match your answers first. We cannot live without water. So the first sentence, the subject will be we. I have already told you what is subject. Subject is the doer of the action. Who is doing the work? So by asking questions like what or whom, you can get your subject. So now if we ask who cannot live without water, the answer will be we. So your subject is we. So it is we or who. If you ask yourself, the answer will be your subject. Okay, next one. My brother won a trophy. Now who won a trophy? My brother, obviously answer. So what is your subject? It will be my brother. So this way you need to just underline your subjects. She was proud of her achievements. Who was proud? She. So she is your subject. I have already told you it can be a noun or it can be a pronoun. So here she is your pronoun. The poor woman lives in an old hut. Who? Poor woman. So your subject is what? Poor woman. Next, number 5. The milk was too hot to drink. What? Milk. Yes. So the milk is your subject. Isn't it easy? So coming to next one, Shaurya had a terrible stomach ache. Who? Shaurya. So what is your subject here? Shaurya. Number 7. Siddharth tried to solve the riddle. Who? Siddharth. So our subject is Siddharth. Coming to the 8th one now, I always speak the truth. Who speaks? I. So I is your subject. Coming to the 9th one, mother wanted to attend the exhibition. Who wanted to attend the exhibition? Mother. So mother is your subject. Coming to the 10th one now, bird watching is my favorite hobby. Which is your favorite hobby? bird watching. What is, you will draw a line, and what is your verb? It is. Helping verb is there. Coming to the third one, Little Red Riding Hood was not afraid of the big bad wolf. Now ask yourself a question, who was not afraid? You will get your answer. Little Red Riding Hood. After that, you will draw a line to segregate your predicate. And now see, what is the verb here? Again, it is helping verb was that is given to you. So you will write was. Alice got lost in the forest. Who? Alice. That is your subject. Draw a line to separate predicate. Now see the verb. It is got lost. Lost is an action verb, so we will write got lost, get lost. Goldilocks ate the porridge on the table. Who? Goldilocks. So this is your subject. Separate it by drawing a line like this. Now, what is going on? Action of eating, that is ate, is going on. So ate is your verb. What is porridge? It is dalia. So coming to the sixth one now. The hen was frightened of the wicked fox. Who? The hen. So this is your subject. Subject it. Was frightened. We have helping verb as well as we have the main verb. So we'll write was frightened as a verb. Coming to the seventh one now. Aunt Jennifer's fingers fluttered through the wool. Now who's aunt? Jennifer's. Just see the spelling. J-E-N-N-I-F-E-R-S plus fingers. So this whole is the subject. Then separate it. And then fluttered through the wool. What is your subject verb here? What action is being going on? It is of fluttering. So fluttered is your verb to be written in the blank. It is main verb. Tom painted the fence with the help of his friends. Who painted? Tom. Now separate it and your verb. Action of painting is going on, so it is painted. So this way you will separate your subject from the predicate and also write down your verb. Next we have the ninth one. So let us see the ninth one now. The sentence is Aunt Polly knew the truth. Who? Aunt Polly. So Aunt Polly, it's the name of a lady, is your subject. Then separate it like this and now write the verb. Knew. Past of know. So this is your verb. The group joined the brimming river. Now who? The group. Separate it. What is the verb? Joined. Act of joining is going on, so this is your verb. So this way you will subject and predicate identify. You will identify your subject as well as the predicate and then write down the verb. I hope you have done this exercise now. Let's come to exercise E. Again, it was given for homework. You have to provide the subject. For example, Dash hunted the wild birds. The hunter obviously. Dash lives in the Rashtrapati Bhavan, the Prime Minister. Already I have explained you these sentences and I have told you there will be the same answers. So let us discuss. Dash is called the father of the nation. Who is called the father of the nation? Let's see exercise E. Third one, first two I have already done that day. So it is always Gandhiji, who is known as the father of nation. Coming to the fourth one, Dash is my favorite story. Which is your favorite story? You can write down the name of any story. As for me, it's Alice in Wonderland. I hope you like to read stories, watch stories. So you can write down the name of any story. Dash visits the temple every day. You can say my grandfather, my grandmother. As for me, I have written my grandmother. Coming to the sixth one now. Dash is the 10th month of the year. We all know, you can count it. What is the 10th month? October. And it is proper noun, always beginning with the capital letter. Okay, coming to the next one. Dash is a festival of India. We all know India is a land of many festivals. So you can write down the name of any one festival. Diwali is my favorite festival, so I will write down Diwali. You can write down your own festival. Coming to the next one, Dash writes poems. Now you have to write the name of any of the poet. You can write down Tulsidas, you can write down Kalidas. I love poems of Shakespeare. Or William Wordsworth, he was a poet as well as a novelist. So I love his poem based on nature, so I will write his name. So Dash are rotten. What can be rotten? Rotten means gala hua, sada hua. So you can write down apples. You can write down any of the name of the vegetable or fruits. So I will write apples are rotten. Coming to the 10th one. Dash a day keeps the doctor away. This is a well-known proverb. We all know apple a day keeps the doctor away. Dash is knocking on the door. You can say, my uncle is knocking at the door. I'll write down the 11th one here. My uncle. You can say my servant, my maid, my father, my mother, anything. Any person can be there on the door. Number 12. Dash make honey. Who makes honey? We all know it is honeybees. So I write down 12. Honeybee makes honey. So it is make, so we will write honeybees. It always goes the opposite. I have told you, if subject is plural, then your verb is singular. If your subject is singular, then your verb is plural. But since it is given make, so we will make a subject plural by writing honey bees. So this way you will do this exercise. I hope you might have done and you can check out your answers. If you have not done, please do it right now. So let's see exercise E. Now you have to provide the F. Sorry. Now you have to provide the predicates in the sentences just as we have done the subjects. So I hope you have done. Let us see this exercise number F now. So let's see the first sentence. The earth, we all know earth revolves around the sun. So it will be predicate we need to add on. The earth revolves around the sun. Earth is a planet and it revolves around the sun. So this way you will add on your predicate. So you can also say the earth is blue in color. Breakfast. What you can add on for breakfast, I have written is, breakfast should be very nutritious. Should be very nutritious. You can add on your own this way. Coming to the third one, December is the last month of the year. Is the last month of the year. You can say December is the coldest month. That is also correct. Then the soldiers fought bravely. So this way you will write down your own predicates. So India Gate is a famous monument. One thing you should take care that there should be always a verb or a helping verb in the predicate. You always start your predicate with either a helping verb or a main verb like this, fought. So that is your predicate. Coming to the sixth one, the garden looked beautiful. Okay, my notebook is very neat and clean. Next is Holi is the festival of colors. So this way we will write down the predicates. Let's come to the 9th one now. So what is the subject here? The bookstall. The bookstall was full of variety of story books, you can see. Coming to the 10th one, the baby slept in the pram. So this way you can write down your own also. Number 11, the Guptas are known for their kindness. This means the Guptas is a very reputed family known for their kindness. The peacock is a national bird. I hope you all know that which is a national bird. Yes, it is peacock. So this way you will write down the predicates. Now let us see the next one. What is there? So that was all for this subject and predicate. After that we have started one new topic, that is prefixes and suffixes. So the first one was done by me, that is on page number 29. Then I have asked you to go through the rules on page number 30. Then 31 we had one exercises in which some prefixes were there, some suffixes were there, and you have to form three new words using those suffix and prefix. So I have already made two words. So I hope you have made the third one. It was very simple in the manner as I have took, and the root word should have a meaning. So you can just do it yourself. I'm not going to take that. Next exercise we have on page number 31. That is based on suffixes and prefixes. Exercise question number is 4 and it's on page number 31. Let us see what is it. It was given for homework. Add the suffixes er, r or ier to change these verbs into nouns. I have given you the example how you will change these verbs into nouns by adding these suffixes. Example, they have given you er, r, or, or ier. So let us take up the first one, do. You will add on doer. So it becomes doer. Number 2, act, actor. This way you will change it into a noun. Act is a verb, but we have to change it into noun. Third, carry, carrier. We always add ier. Next one, wander, wanderer. Simply ER. Then we have fifth one as operate, which will be operator. Number 6 you have invent, and it will be inventor. One who invents something, that person is known as inventor. So it is a noun. Number 7 is your purify, so it will be purifier. This way. Number 8. Next you have distribute. One who distribute things is known as distributor of goods. You can see. Number 9. Write. We all know one who writes story, poem is known as writer. Then create obviously is the creator with O-R. So this way we have transformed the verbs into nouns by adding some suffixes like ER, OR, IER. So this was very easy exercise. Next exercise number B, we have already discussed fill in the blanks by adding a prefix or suffix. This was done already, so I'm not going to take it back again. Then you have exercise number C on page number 32. So let's see exercise number C now. So let us take exercise C now on page number 32. So what we need to do is you need to first match the column A with column B to their opposites. Then add prefix un, u and un to the words in column B. That is just that as they have given. Happy changes to unhappy. So what you have done is by making the second column unhappy, you have made a synonym of column A, that is sad. So this way we need to do this exercise. So let us quickly see. It was given for homework. Please check your answers. First let us just match the following. I'm not going to write it on the board. I'm just telling you first all the answers, and then I will write the correct series that comes to here. Second one, false. What is the opposite of false? It is true. So J part is answer number 2. You can write down number 2 in front of J. Third, not sure is certain. Opposite is certain, that is sure. Then messy, number 4, that is messy is very untidy. So opposite of messy is tidy, that is number 4 is G part. Then ill, that is when you are sick, that is number 5 when you are well. Opposite of ill, not complete, that is number 6, it is finished. So not complete, which is incomplete, finished, the opposite of it. Different, number 7, you have like. Different is something different, like is same. Then cruel, number 8, then you have for it kind. One who is very kind is the opposite of cruel. Done to shoelaces. Now number 9, it is what? It is tie. Done to shoelaces is what? When you untie your shoelaces. And opposite of it is what? It is tie. Last one, take things out of a box. When you take the things out of a box, what is that? The opposite of that. That is you pack. Take out the things, that is unpack. And pack is the opposite of unpack. So this way, I hope you have done it. Let's check the series now. It will be 8, 10, 7, 6, 5, 9, 4, 3, 1 and 2. When you get all the opposites, so this way you will get your series in your book. Now what you will do is, just as in front of number 2, what is false, it is true. So in front of number 2, in the third column, you will write down, this is for number 2, you will write down un plus true, that is untrue, and that will be just the synonym of false. Next, not sure, we have already done, it is un plus certain in column number 3. Coming to the fourth one, we have messy, that is un plus tidy. So it is the same meaning as of column number 1. Ill, un plus well. I hope you are getting what we are doing. Number 6, not complete, that is un plus finished. Number 7, then you have different, that is un plus like. Number 8, we have un plus kind, that is cruel. Number 9, you have un plus tie, that is untie. Number last, you have unpack. Un plus pack is unpack. That is opposite, the same meaning of take things out of a box. So this way we will do the exercise number C. I hope you have understood. If you have checked your answers, very good. Otherwise, you can just note down your answers in the book itself. Then exercise number D was given as homework. Even ones I have discussed, and the odd ones I have asked you to do it from home. So let us discuss the odd ones now of exercise D on page number 33. So what is the exercise? Let us see it. So what you have to do in this exercise is, you have to add suitable prefix or suffix to the words that are given in the box, and looking at the sense of the sentence, you need to complete your fill-up. So the even ones I have already done. Let us see the odd ones, that is sentence number 1. If we take, my aunt's children never say please or thank you. They are very dash. So one who does not say please or thank you, you can say the person can be unpleasant. So this way you will fill in this exercise. So let us write down unpleasant. I hope you have done it in your books. Coming to the third one, I wish I was not dash, but I truly don't like meeting people. I wish I was not unsociable. Sociable word is given. Sociable is one who loves to meet people. But then he says that you have to add a prefix or a suffix according to the sense. So I wish I was not unsociable means he wished that he had been sociable. This way, coming to number 5, we can't assign assign any task to Ramit as he is very. Now see the word, what can be there? It can be responsible, but then we have to add prefix to make it responsible. You cannot give any work to the person who is irresponsible. So we need to add on prefix. This way you have to see what you will add on, a prefix or a suffix according to the sense of the sentence. Coming to the seventh one, this riddle is dash to solve. Possible to solve? No, we will write possible is already given, and to that word we need to add on prefix or suffix. So we will write impossible to solve. So what we have done is we have added I am as a prefix. Coming to the ninth and the last one, the candidate's handwriting was absolutely, if we say legible, that is, that can be very easily understood, very neat and clean, but was absolutely illegible and could not be read. So it is could not be read. So we'll write here illegible. So what we have done is again we have added IL to legible to make it illegible as a prefix. So this way you need to do this exercise if you have not done. Coming to the last exercise of suffix and prefix, that is exercise E, was given for homework. What you have to do is, again you need to complete the fill-ups by adding prefixes to the words given in the brackets. Only you need to add on prefix, not suffix, but only prefix. Attempts to communicate in a foreign language can easily go wrong. So there is one paragraph given, according to that you need to fill in the blanks. I was disappointed by my attempts to speak Greek on my last holiday. The waiter dash what I wanted. So it will be the waiter misunderstood. Please check your answers. Misunderstood. What I wanted and brought me mushrooms instead of beetroots. I dash mushrooms greatly. So it will be I dislike. This is your prefix here. Dislike mushrooms greatly, but when I asked him to replace them, replace them with beetroots, he smiled and went to the kitchen and brought me a plate of meat chops. He also dashed my attitude towards everyone, that is, untook. When you don't care of anyone's good habit. So, untook my attitude towards everyone when I complained that they had cooked the meat, means overcooked now. Overcooked the meat, the waiter grinned and twirled his mustache. Grinned means smiled and twirled his mustache like this. I finally dashed the bill, that is misread. So, I finally misread the bill. And number 7, and accused them of charging me, that is overcharging me. Overcharging me. Next, everything was my fault. The language problem made traveling convenient will be inconvenient. So, if this is a passage about your journey to a foreign land in which you happen to converse in their language, but since you are unable to speak their language and you converse in your own language, so then that communication problem becomes a problem for you. The concept, what you want, is misunderstood by the people of that country. So it is good when you go to other place, then you should learn the language first of that place so that there is no miscommunication between you and the other person. So this is very interesting passage. I must learn the language. I must relearn. So now he is accepting his mistake and he says that he should relearn the language, else my stay would be an unhappy one. Happy one? Unhappy one. So I had to change my hotel because the staff ill-treated me and made me very comfortable. Changes to uncomfortable. So this way say you need to complete the passage. I hope you have done the last exercise of prefix and suffix. With this we finish the discussion of all the homework exercises and also our April syllabus. Tomorrow onwards we are going to start afresh with the syllabus of May. So I have already given you the syllabus, just go through it once. Thank you, stay safe, stay tuned.